TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Wednesday, the 1st of January. Two soldiers killed in gun battle in India's Jammu and Kashmir. At least 17 killed due to hazardous levels of air pollution in Afghan capital. And India rings in 2020 with fireworks, revelry and prayers. And now for all the details, two Indian Army soldiers were killed in a gunfight with militants in Rajouri district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Wednesday. The soldiers had reportedly detected the terrorists trying to sneak in from Pakistan using forest cover. Operations were still going on till the last reports came in.
Two Indian Army soldiers were killed in a gun battle during a cordon and search operation in Rajouri district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Wednesday. A massive operation was still going on in Noshera sector of Rajouri district till the last reports came in. The soldiers had reportedly detected some terrorists trying to sneak in from Pakistan using forest cover. The search operation was launched following specific information about the movement of suspected terrorists.
अपना नजर रखी गई है और पूरे आर्मी और पुलिस जो सर्चिंग चला रही है और नाके लगे हुए हैं टाउन के आगे पीछे बैग में और अपने जहाँ जहाँ जो रोड आ रहे हैं टाउन में वहाँ ही सर्चिंग चल रही है और गाड़ी को चेक किया जा रहा है.
This came a day after the region's police chief Dilbagh Singh said that there was a 30% dip in terror-related incidents in Jammu and Kashmir in 2019 and a decrease in the number of infiltrations into the valley as compared to last year. India has long blamed Pakistan for aiding and infiltrating terrorists from across the border to spread unrest in Kashmir Valley.
Former Indian Army Chief General Bipin Rawat took charge as the first Chief of Defence Staff on Wednesday and inspected the Tri-Services Guard of Honour in capital New Delhi. He said as the newly appointed Chief of Defence Staff, his task is to create synergy between different wings of the armed forces.
Former Indian Army Chief General Bipin Rawat took charge as the first Chief of Defence Staff or CDS on Wednesday and said that his task is to create synergy between different wings of the armed forces. General Rawat inspected the Tri-Services Guard of Honour at South Block Lawns in capital New Delhi. He will act as the principal military advisor to Defence Minister on all matters related to the Army, Navy and Air Force. The CDS will also head the Department of Military Affairs to be created within the Ministry of Defence. While interacting with media, General Rawat said his aim would be to integrate the efforts being made by the three services and work as a team.
Chief of Defence Staff ka jo task cut out hai, wo hai tino service ko ekjut hokar saksham banana. Aur hum isi taraf karwai karte rahenge. Main aapko ye yakin dilana chahunga ki isme Army, Navy, Air Force ek saath teamwork karte hue karwai karenge. CDS जो है उनके ऊपर नियंत्रण रखेगा, लेकिन कार्रवाई जो होगी वो टीमवर्क के जरिए होगी.
Meanwhile, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi took to Twitter to congratulate General Rawat. PM Modi expressed his delight over the appointment and said that General Rawat is an outstanding officer who has served India with great zeal. General Bipin Rawat, who demitted office on retirement as Chief of Indian Army on December 31st, earlier in the day, also led wreath and paid homage to the martyrs at the National War Memorial in New Delhi.
The Indian Space Research Organization is currently working on the Chandrayaan 3 mission to Moon project, the space agency's chief, K. Sivan, said on Wednesday. He also said that four astronauts have been selected to undergo training in Russia for the ambitious manned mission in space.
Indian Space Research Organization or ISRO Chairman K. Sivan on Wednesday said that India is looking forward to sending its third mission to Moon after ambitious Chandrayaan 1 and 2. The configuration of Chandrayaan 3 will be similar to its predecessor, with a propulsion module, a lander and a rover, minus the orbiter, which is already in place with Chandrayaan 2. The ISRO chief also informed that four astronauts from Indian Air Force have been selected to undergo training in Russia for its ambitious manned mission in space Gaganyaan.
Chandrayaan 3 is government has approved, and it is that the project is now formed. The activity is going on Chandrayaan 3 very smoothly, and Chandrayaan 3 configuration will be almost similar to Chandrayaan 2.
Chandrayaan 2 mission was India's first attempt to land on lunar surface. The ISRO had planned the landing on the south pole of the lunar surface. However, the lander Vikram hard landed.
Moving on, locals in Gilgit-Baltistan have blamed that the illegally occupied region continues to witness blatant human rights violations by Pakistan. They said Pakistani authorities persecute the common people and activists in the region for raising their voices against the injustice meted out to them.
The illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan continues to witness blatant human rights violations at the hands of the Pakistani authorities. Residents blame the incapacitated government in Gilgit-Baltistan is run and directed by Islamabad to persecute the common people and activists who raise their voices against the injustice meted out to them. The Pakistani establishment has framed dozens under the draconian Schedule 4 of Anti-Terrorism Act over the years, not only to give itself a free rein to rule the region, but also to send a threatening message to all sections of the society.
اور گلگت بلتستان میں مختلف شعبوں سے تعلق رکھنے چاہے وہ طلبہ ہو سیاسی عہدیداران ہو سیاسی جدوجہد کرنے والے کارکنان ہو ان کو شیڈول فور ایٹی اے کے مقدمات اور دوسرے کالے قوانین کے ذریعے ان کی زبان بندی اور ان کی جو جدوجہد کو روکنے کی جو کوشش کی جا رہی ہے یہ بھی یقیناً انسانی حقوق کی سنگین خلاف ورزی میں کے زمرے میں آتا ہے اور اس حوالے سے ہم مطالبہ کرتے ہیں
یہاں گلگت بلتستان میں پاکستان میں کہیں اور شاید سیاسی اسیران نہ ہوں لیکن یہاں پہ سیاسی اسیر ہیں خاص طور سے ثانی عطا آباد کے بعد جو جن لوگوں کے اوپر مقدمات بنے تھے وہ آج بھی جیلوں کے اندر مقید ہیں اور اس کے علاوہ بھی آپ میڈیا کی صورتحال اور دیگر جو ہے خواتین بچے لیبر اور ان کی صورتحال کو دیکھیں تو کافی انسانی حقوق کے حوالے سے یہاں مشکلات موجود ہیں
Pakistan makes huge claims at international platforms, but the ground reality reeks of a rapidly deteriorating human rights situation in the illegally occupied region.
In news from Afghanistan, Afghanistan's defense ministry in a statement on Tuesday claimed that at least 117 insurgents were neutralized in the past 24 hours in military operations and airstrikes by Afghan security forces across the country.
Afghanistan's Ministry of Defense on Tuesday claimed that Afghan security forces killed at least 117 insurgents in the past 24 hours in 22 offensive and clearance operations and 32 airstrikes carried across the country. This came as at least 14 Afghan security force members were killed after the Taliban stormed a security checkpoint in Afghanistan's northern province of Jawzjan on Monday. A provincial government spokesman said. Fighting rages across Afghanistan as Taliban militants have been attempting to take territory and consolidate their positions during winters in the country. Taliban, which ruled the country before being ousted in late 2001, has continued violence, killing hundreds of government troops as well as civilians over the years. At least 17 pro-government local militia men were killed on Saturday night when they fought back Taliban militants in northern Takhar province.
More news from Afghanistan. At least 17 people have died due to respiratory infections and related health conditions over the past week in Afghan capital Kabul amid a spike in the country's pollution levels.
At least 17 people have been killed by the extreme air pollution in Afghanistan over the past 1 week, media reports said on Tuesday. Afghanistan's public health ministry, which began an anti-pollution campaign on Monday, has said that over 8,800 patients suffering from respiratory conditions, including common cold and lung problems, visited government hospitals in Afghan capital Kabul over the past week, local media reported. According to officials, the spike in pollution levels is due to the use of low-quality fuel, including coal for warming government buildings, wedding halls, houses and some other private businesses. In Afghanistan, people usually use low-quality fuel to keep their houses and offices warm in winter.
As many as 55 artists from across India and other countries are showcasing the beauty of their cultural heritage and identities in an art exhibition currently underway in eastern Odisha province. The exhibition reflects a wide variety of art and ideas of the participating artists.
As many as 55 artists from across India and other countries are showcasing the beauty of their cultural heritage and identities in an ongoing art exhibition in Eastern Bhubaneswar city. The artists are stimulating the visual senses of visitors, especially art lovers, using an amalgamation of colors and various other media. The Nalabanda International Art Exhibition is reflecting a wide variety of art and ideas of the participating artists. Various art forms and different themed paintings are also on display. The organizer of the event, Soumyaranjan Nayak, said the exhibition was a delight for all the art lovers as they got to know about various cultural heritage and identities of artists from different countries.
Isko expand karne ke liye hum sare fields se log yahan pe matlab invite karte hain aur hame bhi maza aata hai aur wo unse hum kuch seekhte hain aur humse wo log bhi kuch seekhne ki koshish karte hain.
I would like to say thanks to the organizer team, and I'm feeling very happy. It's a great environment where we get together from different countries, different continent. All the artists are here together. It's a great environment.
The artists are depicting traditional ideas and concepts through modern art, paintings and sculptures. The six-day-long event that began on December 28th will conclude on 2nd of January.
People across India on Wednesday welcomed New Year with fireworks, dance and music. Locals and tourists gathered in many bustling cities to witness stage performances and dance the night away to celebrate the arrival of the new year.
People across India rang in the new year 2020 with fireworks, dance, music and prayers as the clock struck midnight on Wednesday. Tourists and local residents in India's western Mumbai city gathered at the Gateway of India monument in huge numbers to witness light show and fireworks. People also danced and cheered to welcome the new year with pomp and fervor.
New year mein bas acche se nikle, sab kuch acha ho, aur jis tarah shuruaat hui hai us tarah se pura saal acche se jaye.
In capital New Delhi, people gathered at Connaught Place area with friends and family and blew horns as they bid farewell to 2019. The city was abuzz with activity as both young and old took part in the festivities with gaiety.
Kya mil karke rahe sare jitne bhi dharm hai yahan ke sare uska festivals ko hum respect de agar hum khushi na de pate usme gham bhi na de main ye kehna chahta hu sab logo se ki happy new year all of you.
Meanwhile, huge crowd of devotees flocked to the holiest shrine of Sikhism, the Golden Temple in northern Amritsar city early in the day to offer prayers and mark the auspicious beginning of the new year.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. Two soldiers killed in gun battle in India's Jammu and Kashmir. At least 17 killed due to hazardous levels of air pollution in Afghan capital. And India rings in 2020 with fireworks, revelry and prayers. Now, viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also Visit us on facebook.com/SAsianNewsline and follow us on Twitter at SAsianNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.